Welcome! Today we're going to talk about better audio work habits and specifically how to use a drawing tablet in combination with your DAW. So let's go! Yeah, so I've been using tablets with DAWs for quite a long time now. In the past I used this Wacom Intous Pro Medium. And one good thing about this Wacom Intous Pro Medium is that it was wireless. So you could use... There's a little adapter that comes with the device. It's just a small little USB connector. Little device that you connect to your computer and then it will be able to talk to you, this Wacom device. But now I have this more recent Wacom Intous device. And the reason I upgraded is because this new one is multi-touch sensitive. So we will look at how to use that with the DAW. Very fun with lots of birds. So this is the layout of the device. You have your drawing area or your touch area here. Yeah, and the Wacom Intous Pro comes with a Pro Pen 2. And it has this nice little stand that you can put the pen in. And if you open this... If we can get it open, you can see that we have a few different pen tops to use in different materials. Some of them are in felt and some are in plastic. So that's also very convenient if you prefer to have a softer tip on your pen. But mostly while working in the DAW, I'm using just my fingers on this device. And the great thing for studio ergonomics is that you can have your hands placed naturally. Unlike when using a mouse, you stretch out your arm and thus you have easier to get this tennis elbow injury. As you can see, we can zoom in without doing any special setups. We can directly use this touch device with logic to zoom in and by using three fingers, it's like if you're pressing down the mouse with the left button, so you can drag these MIDI events around. You can also copy them by pressing down one of the keys on this tablet. And I also set up this board to be able to add instrument tracks and add MIDI tracks. So that's a very convenient function to have directly from your tablet. Okay, so I showed you how to move around clips. We can go in and do MIDI editing. Select notes, move them around. And of course, as we have access to the Alt command and Shift keys, you can also copy notes. We can zoom and we can move with two fingers, moving sideways or scroll your track. So that's also very convenient when you're editing equalizers. Three fingers to adjust the curve, one finger to use it as a regular mouse. Yeah, so by using a tablet you really prevent repetition injuries because you're working in a more natural position. Of course it's always good to have some variation in your working position, so it's good to jump between maybe using the tablet some days or using the tablet before lunch and then after the lunch maybe use the mouse for a while. Personally, I'm using the tablet most of the time for the editing and for DAW specific tasks. There's also a scroll wheel on this tablet, but I've not set it up with the DAW yet, but maybe I will do that at a later stage. Yeah, so I highly recommend using a Wacom tablet for audio work and audio editing because it really prevents repetitive strain injuries and it can be a good part of your workflow. Yeah, so that's how you can use the Wacom tablet with the Logic Pro X. And if we go to Bitwig Studio, of course, we can also use this Wacom tablet with Bitwig Studio. And if you hold three mouse buttons, three fingers, at the timeline and drag down or drag up, you can zoom in and zoom out. You can't pinch like you can do in Logic, but you can do this instead, drag up and down. You can, of course, select clips and you can move clips around and copy them. And of course, you can control volumes by dragging left or right with three fingers. And as with Logic, I've set up Bitwig to add audio tracks and or add instrument tracks just by pressing a key on the one of the keys on the tablet. And of course, you can also make use of a Wacom device in FL Studio, so we can pinch to zoom and copy and move around tracks. Like so. And by holding a finger above the each button, they are capacitive, so they will show you which key press they corresponds to. This is Shift, Command, Option, Pan, Scroll. And then you have some other buttons up here. So that's very neat, so you don't have to go to the system preferences just to look up what of the buttons corresponds to what key press. Neat. And of course, you can make use of the tablet to paint and do a lot of other tasks on your computer. So I highly recommend that you check out the Wacom Intous Pro for your audio workflow. I hope you like this video, and please subscribe if you're new, like if you like. If you have any questions on using a tablet with your DAW, please let me know in the comments. And now you can continue and watch my next video. Thanks for watching today, and see you in the next video. Bye. Lots of birds. Birdie num num. Birdie num num. Party party little.